Hemant, congratulations for this fantastic feat that was been achieved by Abhimanyu, the youngest GM in history of chess. What was your first feeling when you were in the playing hall, and I assume that you saw him winning his game?
Thanks a lot, Sagar, for the wishes. I mean, I would say relieved. I mean, he has been missing that for last few tournaments by 1 point, half point, 1 point, and it was painful to go through these tournaments, but I mean, we were relieved after that. So, I mean, we can't ask for anything more. I mean, this is the best thing happened to us in our whole life. I mean, this is nothing can match that.
Yeah, I agree. Just showing you this list of youngest GMs in the world right now. You can see the names there. Karjakin right there at the top. Then you have Gukesh, Sindarov, Pragnananda, Nodir Beck, Negi, Carlsen, Weihe. And to top them all is Abhimanyu there as the youngest GM. Did you believe that he could achieve it? I mean, especially because of the pandemic and all the situation.
Yeah, pandemic changed the whole equation. I mean, when he had 1 year, 9 months, I was very sure that we are going to make it. We were going to make it, and we wanted to come to Europe 9 or 10 months before. And then I planned two Europe trips, so that last year one trip and one trip this year. But then pandemic changed the whole equation, and I mean, not that many tournaments in those 14 months. So I kept telling him that some tournaments we will get, and we don't have luxury to play as many tournaments as other people have got to play, who attempted this record, who are chasing this record. And luckily in Hungary, we got those tournaments. So that's the whole reason we did not take any break also, because we were desperately looking for tournaments. And even though it was painful playing every day one game or sometimes two games a day nonstop for over 2.5 months, it was very difficult, but we had no option but to play.
Yeah, I mean, playing one game every day, one thing. Other thing also that, you are far away from your family, you have a wife, your daughter at home, 80 days. How was that? How difficult was that?
I mean, it was more of a firefighting every day. So we really, frankly, we did not get time to think about that. I mean, every day there was a game to prepare against the opponent, what went wrong in the current game, what could have been improved. And along with that, I was working remotely also. So that collectively, we did not get any time to think about that, hardly getting any sleep, and getting 6 hours of sleep was a luxury. So time just flied in that period.
So you are saying that you did your work as a
Yes.
professional, and you are also helping Abhimanyu prepare. What's your role as a as his chess in his chess? What do you do?
I mean, we get the games for the opponents, and we try to figure out what can be done. Of course, I mean, I just come up with some ideas, but the final decision is always by Arun. We have generally have an open discussion about this is what we want to try, we want to play. Like today's game, we as Black are playing against Leon, it was definitely not an easy game. So we wanted to take chances, we wanted to play a sharp line, even though it looked equal for a very long time. We knew that if opponent can come under time pressure, there is always some chance or the other. And we had nothing to lose technically, because it's a draw, it's a draw, you can't do much, but not all equal positions are draw. And he missed the same way last seventh round game. It was a dead equal game, and he messed up in the last minute. He was winning earlier, but even in the end, it was a dead equal game, and he blundered. So these things happened. So we were just hoping that take the game into that territory and work it out that way.
When he blundered the seventh round, what was your feeling like? Because you know that he's got a wild card in the World Cup. So now you cannot play more norm events, right? You have to go there, which is a nice
Yes.
thing, I mean, to go to the World Cup, but that delays his Grandmaster title.
Yes.
you would have
I mean,
felt quite disappointed, right, at that point.
yeah, I could not sleep all night. I mean, it was really bad. And I mean, I always tell him that if opponent played well, you got into some opening issue, something. But in that whole game, if you see, he was better throughout. And I mean, somehow he could not convert that, and then he did not even offer a draw in that game. Ideally, he should have offered a draw because he was under severe time pressure and it was equal position. So at least get half point out of that. If that was the case, he would have got the cushion to settle for a draw in the last round. But he was also, but again, it's easier to say all that because in the middle of a game, once you, and I think it's good that he lost that game because in this game, he did not have plan B. There was only one way, which is to win the game and keep pressing throughout. So that kind of helped to get the, I mean, there was nothing to worry about and just there was only one plan to work
You know, hearing you speak,
on.
Hemant, I feel like you are so involved in his chess journey in a way. Are you also a chess player as such? Like, have you also played chess before?
Yes, I used to play when I was in college or in my earlier company, corporate league. I used to play, but I don't have a FIDE ID or USCF ID. But I'm more of a 1400 rated player, 1400, 1500.
Wow. But you feel that you're still able to add value to Abhimanyu's play?
Yes, I mean, the good thing is that in general, I mean, there have been, this is just one such good tournament, but on a monthly basis, we have been dealing with failures only. I mean, you pick up any month, there were more failures. Left and right, there were failures. So, and we were fortunate enough that all the players were always, I mean, especially the higher rated grandmasters or international masters when he was young, I always used to request them if they can give some tips on what could be improved in his game and all that. And I got a lot of feedback. People were so helpful. And we kept working on that.
But you know, when you ask for a lot of feedback, it sometimes is like there are opposing views, and as a parent, sometimes it starts getting confusing, right? As to what is right, what is not.
Yeah, that's where the role of Magesh and Arun is very important. I mean, there were some cases where those conflicting feedback was there, and then they were always open. I mean, like they are seasoned grandmasters, and I used to just propose that this is what somebody mentioned that you should play this opening. I'm not just professional as such, but they were always ready to listen and then give their feedback. And the final decision always used to be of Arun and Magesh. But we were always open for any feedback, and in that whole process, people gave a lot of feedback. I mean, we were lucky to get some very good feedback all along, and that helped in a big way.
Very nice, very open. You were talking about Arun and Magesh, so I would you would say that Arun on the left, Magesh, and Magesh's wife Anupritha, who was the first coach of Abhimanyu, they played a very big role, yes, in
Yeah, I mean,
Abhimanyu's.
they treated him like their own kid. I mean, I have never seen any coaches working so hard with the players. I mean, they are just, I mean, we were blessed to have them associated with Abhi. I mean, this is really great.
Yeah. And also, I think he got a little bit of training from the Kasparov Chess Foundation as well, right?
Yes, I mean that also played a big part because just to be in the same room with Kasparov and then talking up, listening to him about chess passionately, that itself is a big thing. I mean, I was in that room and I mean that's really amazing the way and the game analysis also was there. Even there, every 6 months these players have to. So there was a. There was a 3-day rigorous interview process. So they invited about 15 players all over the world for that. And Abhi was the youngest when he was 9. And there was a 3-day rigorous interview where player has to present 6 of their games, 2 wins, 2 losses, 2 draws. And that was a 2-day session. And then the 3rd day they had to solve the studies, whatever they give. all those chess puzzles.
Hmm.
So, I mean, all that experience was really good. And then there was a final day, there was a session with the parent also. So I got the opportunity to talk to Gary, and I mean, this is just amazing. I mean, the charisma, the way he talks and the understanding. And I requested them to allow me to be in that room when they were analyzing Abhi's game, because I mean, I used to take the notes any opportunity. So when Abhi used to present those six games, they allowed me. And then every game, every word he spoke about in a given position, why, how, I just wrote down everything. And then we had sessions with Arun and Magesh. And we always had an action item for what can be fixed in a longer run.
Wow. Wow. Amazing. That's just so brilliant. You know, we wrote an article on Abhimanyu. I mean, we have written several, but there was one where you had mentioned all the expenses that you have incurred as a chess parent. And to tell you the truth, a lot of people were just stunned to read this. You know, they thought that, okay, chess career would not be so expensive. And you have written that close to $200,000 have been spent already on his chess training. I mean, on his chess journey as such. That is huge.
Yes, I mean, this is, for all practical purposes, this is like another mortgage for us for the last 7 years. So that, but I mean, luck, we just wanted to make sure that as long as he is willing to put efforts, financial aspect should not come. So we put all our saving in that. And I mean, it's not just the result. I mean, in general, this is a very royal game. It's a royal game, and it will help player to take better decisions in life for sure. So that pressure of, I mean, all it's very close to life. It will help him no matter what he does in life. It will help him for sure.
Yes, that's one thing to take chess as something that will help you in other phases of life. But here you have just put in everything that you have, your time, your money. Where does that motivation come from? Did you see that Abhimanyu had something special and then this game, or was it like a predetermined thing that I want to make him into a champion?
It was predetermined. I mean, I keep telling him that there were a lot of failures. I mean, there were a lot of failures, and I just wanted to make sure. I mean, the main thing is that, I mean, like when I was growing up, the options were limited. I mean, at that time, we were supposed to either go in medical or engineering and then get a job. That kind of thing was there. But here I thought we should go do something different. I mean, getting into engineering and then routine job, we should try something more. And if we can try, why not? I mean, he delivered. I mean, when I look back, there have been too many failures. That's what this is exactly same thing which I told him today, that he failed hell lot of times. I mean, he's the same guy, world youth. There is nobody in the world chess history who won 8 out of 8 when he played in Brazil and still managed to not get gold.
Then he lost all three, right?
He drew one, and then the next two games he lost from completely winning positions. So he always works hard. I mean, there is no doubt about it. But my only complaint all along was that he doesn't put enough weight on for his own efforts. And in the last 9 months or probably year, last 1 year, he started doing that and he started getting better results.
What do you mean by he doesn't put enough weight for his efforts? Like he doesn't value them. What does that mean?
I mean, he is not disappointed after the losses. I mean, and that bothers me all along, that how come somebody like after messing up in the 7th round also, for him, it was just another game. And for me, it was not. I mean, it was a matter of life and death for me. So it's a different conflicting views all along. And but some coaches told me that that's a good attitude to have. But I think in my personal opinion, one has to be emotionally attached to. One should be committed to whatever you are doing. I mean, working hard is one aspect, but especially after this level, from here to 2600, 2700, now you will be dealing with all the highly motivated, the top 0.1% of the players. So one has to be emotionally attached to everything. And it's very difficult to go further without that. That's what I believe. But I mean, many players told me that, no, it's good to have the other side, the whatever he thinks. It is also another way of looking at it.
Yeah, true. I mean, I have interviewed Henrik Karlsson, father of Magnus Karlsson, and his main takeaway from that interview was, the main statement was that, let the kid own the process. What would you say about that? Because in this case, I see that it's different for Abhimanyu. And do you see that this is also a way, or does it at some point start becoming heavy on the kid as well?
No, it's very heavy on the kid, for sure. I mean, it's very difficult to handle me and the kind of requirements I come. I mean, my last 3 or 4 years, I can tell you frankly that he can't just play the tournament just like that. I mean, it's not like you enroll him to a tournament and play. There are prerequisites to play the tournament. And unless he is done with that prerequisite, he was not allowed to play the tournament.
What are the prerequisites like?
I mean, that is all based on whatever was going on, based on the root cause analysis of everything. I mean, like there were cases, like he got into a problem where there was a double bishop ending and he ran out of ideas and he lost the game. Dead equal game. Mm. So immediately after that, there was an action item to play at least 15 such positions on the board. Play from the real, whatever real games are there. And then, I mean, there was a very awesome game by Grandmaster Ganguly where he had the double bishop advantage. I mean, both players have double bishop.
Yes. With Wang Hao, I believe.
Yes, that game. So right. That game, I sat with him. We worked for 2-3 hours. Every move, you had to try to mimic what Grandmaster Ganguly was thinking. And of course, it was not easy. But with the help of engine and with that game, with annotations. The point is that when you lost a game because of lack of ideas in that position, it should not happen in the next one. Next, I mean, another 2 years or 1 year, it should not happen. And that paid off. I mean, then there were some other game and then he had more ideas because 15 games he worked on. Similarly, double rook ending also, it happened in some game, and whether to trade one pair of rook or not, it was not, I mean, there are no simple rules. There are no simple answers to these questions. But so there was a need to go through 30, 40, 50 games because double rook ending, there were a lot of games. So we worked in that aspect also.
Reminds me of Fischer, you know, when he played in some Olympiad and he lost to Botvinnik in a rook end game. I think he spent the next few months of his life mastering all sorts of rook end games. And he said, I won't play until I've done that. Some kind of similar approach.
Yeah, I mean, Fischer is a role model. I mean, I always tell Abhi that think about a person. First of all, now with engines and all, at least you know, you can try those ideas, what you're thinking, and then you get an answer, whether what you think is right or not, what is the better idea. And then there are multiple engines. You make use of all that information. It's much simpler. On those days when these guys used to spend whole nights figuring out what are the options. I mean, that was the real talent. And the top quality literature was not there in English. So he learned Russian. I mean, that's the motivation. I mean, this is the desire to succeed. Luckily, we are in an age where we don't have to do all that. It's just that whatever information is available, make sure that there is no regression, don't learn. I mean, and anything you learn in end game and middle game, it is not going to backfire in any way. The problem is only in opening, where you pick up some opening and then whatever your current repertoire is, there will be some conflicts and there will be confusion. But middle game maneuvering, end game, it's ocean. And I mean, more and more exposure is going to help for sure.
You see, Abhimanyu has now become a GM. He'll keep getting stronger as the, you know, days go by. Till what point do you see your role in this journey? Like, because there will come a point where you will be like, okay, now it's you, what you have to do, or how would it be?
I mean, the deal was that after he become the GM, I'll go out. That was the deal. But I don't think he is there mentally to push all by himself. So I think another 2 years probably. I mean, I still believe that 2700 by the age of 15 is doable. I mean, it's not that it's easy. Nobody has done that, but it's doable. And if you get the right training and if you work on the right areas, it's possible. I mean, these levels have their own requirements. Like when he became IM, the requirement was to, like, last norm, IM norm. And another thing is that we never played in a lower tournament. So all his IM norms came in a GM section. So becoming youngest IM in the world was never a target technically. I mean, he got that. That was very good. But we never played in an IM invitational tournament. The goal was to play higher and higher. And in that process, there were a lot of painful blows. 35 games without a win. I still remember that. I mean, four tournaments without a win. And nothing was working. Because the opponents were too strong. And it was a 6.5 point norm in US most of the tournaments. So 25-37 average rating. And he was not able to move at all. But the understanding was getting... I mean, it just... More and more understanding, more failures will expose. You will get to know more about that.
Hey, rightly said. Well, tell us about the role of his mother in this entire journey. You know, what has been her role?
I mean, she is very supportive. I mean, it's very painful. I mean, I understand little bit chess and I know what are the goals. I am the goal setter and everything. So I'm not in a supporting role. Basically, it's my fight also, so I'm involved. But for her, it is more painful because she is like, when this will end? I mean, that question used to keep coming, failures after failures, and then whether it is really worth pushing that much. But she was always calm and whatever vision was there, whatever she always supported in all possible ways.
And now your daughter as well is into chess, isn't she?
Yes, she is.
And you plan to be as intense with her as well, or what is it like?
I mean, luckily, she is very different than Abhi. So whatever complaints I have about Abhi, he is a very soft person. Even today, I keep telling him to be aggressive. I keep telling him, it's the other way. But with my daughter... She has all those characteristics already. So I'm really looking forward to start working with her, hopefully. But again, they both are needed. I mean, if you're too aggressive and if you take losses to your heart, it's a painful journey. I mean, every tournament, if there are going to be losses and if you can't handle that. So that's the biggest worry for me. But I hope she will cope up with that and then it will be fun to work with her.
Yeah.
But she is very competitive. I mean, she's very competitive.
Go on.
Yeah, I mean, she was telling him that don't just come without a title. I mean, you are most welcome to US, but come with a title.
What, she's 9 or 10 years old?
She's 7. She will be 8.
7.
Yes.
Wow. And
she reaches 1650. So she did not get chance to play over the board tournaments, but hopefully things will open up soon and I look forward to work with her.
Yeah, I mean, I've seen siblings in India, especially Prag and Vaishali are a good example, two of them. Once they become strong and there's a good kind of coordination, then two people can go in one yes. event together and that makes sense.
Yes, and it was a learning curve for me also because, I mean, I was like a 1300-1400 rated player, so... Understanding what it takes to become IM, understanding, developing yeah. that understanding, what it takes to become GM, what is so different in a 2600 GM versus a 2500 GM. There is a big difference. I mean, how they look at the same game. And once you go to 2700, it's a different ball game. I mean, it doesn't, a 2700 playing 2500, it's not even a game. I mean, the way they play, it's completely different. So that learning curve was there for me. I hope that this will help me to guide her. And with she doesn't need to play that many tournaments. We played a lot of tournaments. I think 100,000 plus games in US. US chess rated, because most of the US chess games are not federated. So they have a separate rating.
Right. Yeah. What's her name?
Ridhima Mishra.
Yeah, we'll be looking forward to Ridhima playing. Looking forward, and also from what you said, I see that cost is one of the biggest elements here, right? Because when you look at training, when you look at working, also when you spoke about, your journey here already, and when we had shared the article, there was this GoFundMe page and you were trying to raise funds. Later on, some funds were raised. I see that now it has raised 6 to 16,000. How has this helped in general, this entire, in the last few days, this fundraising?
This helped in a big way, and I would like to thank all the supporters to support us in this quest, and that took care of all the expenses. The apartment and tournament fee, most of them are getting covered with that. So that really helped in a big way.
Tremendous. And now you are looking at maybe a corporate sponsor, right? Because that would be very important.
Yes, because now from 2500 to 2700, it's going to be very tricky. The problem is that if we are targeting that level, the coaches should be of that rating, and it's very difficult to get super grandmasters, and everything is going to cost more and more. So I'm sincerely hoping that some corporate sponsorship will come, and that will help him. As long as he gets that support, I would like him to go all the way and just keep pushing as much as he can. In terms of, one good thing with him is that from the very early age, he's trained to work hard for very long hours. So that will help him in a long way. Now it's just a matter of more guidance and good tournaments, and things should fall in place.
So your aim for Abhi is that he should become like the world champion, right?
Yes, that's the dream. If that works out, that's really amazing. But the intermediate goal should be 2700 Super GM will be the... that is doable. That's what I think, that should be doable. World Championship, again, there is only one... There can only be one world champion, and there is a lot of competition at the very top. So I don't think... a player's parent can take somebody to that level for sure, because the player has to have it, and that drive all by himself. And even for Super GM, it's not easy. But still, I have a feeling that there are. It's possible with more hard work.
And then, what's your take about education and other phase of life, like how? What should the view be for Abhimanyu? Because when you are a full-time professional, you can see last 80 days here, school has gone for a toss in a way, right?
It's important. It's very important. But somehow I feel that a lot of time, it's not worth spending that much time on school. I have seen people, kids spending so much time on school activities. And I don't think it's worth that much. It should be flexible. Attendance and all those things, it's too much to handle. If the kids are involved in all those activities, it reminds me of, it's like my office work. Like there is always so much to work. So kids also are in the same mode. And if they are in that same mode for a very long period of time, when they have to actually perform at the higher level, or even when they work, I don't think there will be enough steam left. So it's very important, but it should be somewhat moderate. My wife wants him to get straight A's everywhere, and I keep telling her it is impossible. If you're spending so much time on chess, it is not going to happen. So as long as you are above average in your class in other things, it's okay. You have to maintain the balance. And you can only excel in one thing, but as long as other aspects are covered, we should be okay. And we can always come back on studies. So it should be a little bit more flexible.
But for a kid like Abhimanyu, isn't it some kind of a lonely journey? Because, you know, he's playing chess, and when he goes back to school, the other kids are in some other world, all of it, no parties.
Yes, it is painful, and he's a very social guy, so he misses that part. You know, he'll go back to school. So what we did was, we did basically this year, we took a year off. It was like a complete year off to make sure that he can spend enough hours on this school. But he'll go back to regular school.
Yeah. Yeah, well, there are some amazing insights, Hemant, into the world of a top prodigy, how it develops. Also, parenting, I think it's very tough. It requires a lot of focused, one-minded goal. And you've been very candid with us. And I think this will help a lot of other parents who are, you know, in their journey to become, to make their kids into top players. So thank you so much for sharing.
Thank you so much, Sagar, for all the support. I mean, this is really awesome. I mean, people all over the world, they supported him in this quest, and it's really amazing. And the excitement was there. And on social media also, everybody is going through the game, commenting. I mean, that's really amazing to see that. Thanks a lot for everybody for their support and love.
I think Abhimanyu's talent attracts everyone. You know, the way he plays chess, the way he speaks, the way he analyzes, it's just very attractive for the entire world. And I hope that he goes on to play amazingly well at the World Cup, where he will face Bahadur Jobawa. Are you excited for it?
Yes, I am very excited about that. I mean, he should. The game is going to be very difficult, but at the end of the day, I just asked him to put everything on board, whatever he has learned so far. I mean, there should not be easy game for his opponent, for sure. So whatever we can do, we should do that. And it's going to be a good learning experience for him.
Yeah. Well, Hemant, congratulations once again. And thank you so much for your time.
Thanks a lot, Sagar. Have a nice day.